Question 1. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with computers running Windows XP Professional. You want to find out how many user accounts have blank or simple passwords such as God or password. Which of the following tools should you use? A. FnetCHK. B. SCA. C. MBSA. D. CUPDATE. The correct answer is C. MBSA is a tool that is used to scan one or more Windows-based computers for common security holes. The FnetCHK scan will check for missing security updates, therefore, answer A is incorrect. SCA is used to analyze security configurations and resolve security discrepancies based on security templates, therefore, answer B is incorrect. PUPDATE is a command line utility that can be used if the policy needs to be refreshed immediately, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 2. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with computers running Windows XP Professional. You notice that there are no new logon events on one of the servers for the past week. You know users are logging on, and you have verified that the audit policy is configured correctly. What can you do to correct this situation? Choose 2. A. Enable the audit account logon events. B. Increase the size of the log file. C. Change the log setting from manual to override events as needed. D. Enable audit process tracking.
The correct answer is B. C. Auditing is already configured, therefore, answer A is incorrect.
Audit process tracking logs detailed tracking information on program activation, process exit, handle duplication, and indirect object access, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 3. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with computers running Windows XP Professional. Your company has merged with XYZ Company. Both domains are running in 2003 native mode. You need to grant access to resources to a group that is a distribution group of XYZ without affecting email distribution. How do you accomplish this with the least amount of administrative effort? A. Create a new security group and add all users. B. Create new distribution and security groups and then add all users. C. Make the distribution group a universal group. D. Convert the distribution to a security group. The correct answer is D. A security group can also be used as an email entity. Creating a new security group and adding all users is too much administrative effort, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Creating new distribution and security groups and then adding all users is not necessary, therefore, answer B is incorrect. Making the distribution group a universal group will not allow access to resources, therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 4. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with computers running Windows XP Professional. You have several users that need access to stop and start the ESADMIN service on a website on an ESERVER. How do you accomplish this? A. Create a template that has permissions to the web folder containing the site and apply the template. B. Add the users to the local administrators group. C. Configure their user accounts as service accounts. D. Create a group that includes the user accounts and allow full control on the web folder containing the site. The correct answer is A. Security templates are created to grant user rights. Adding the users to the local administrators group or configuring their user accounts as service accounts are both improper security practices, therefore, answers B and C are incorrect. Allowing full control on the web folder containing the site only applies to folder permissions and would not accomplish the task, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 5. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with computers running Windows XP Professional. The help desk group is reporting that the majority of their calls are from users who have locked themselves out of their accounts. The current account lockout threshold is set to 3. What would be your first step to resolve this issue? A. Set the maximum password age policy to 60 days. B. Set the enforce password history policy to 0. C. Set the account lockout duration policy to 20. D. Set the account lockout threshold policy to 5. The correct answer is D. Setting the maximum password age policy to 60 days or enforce password history policy to 0 affect passwords and not account lockout policies. Therefore, answers A and B are incorrect. Although setting the account lockout duration policy to 20 would allow the user's accounts to be reset after 20 minutes. This is not the best solution. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 6. You have configured a new security template with an adjusted password policy to enable complexity requirements for a particular site. You link the policy to the site. You find that the policy has not been completely enforced. Why? A. You did not run sysedit/refresh policy. B. Account policies are applied at the root of the domain. C. You did not run cupdate. D. There is a conflicting policy preventing the new policy from being applied. The correct answer is B. The policy is applied at the root of the domain and becomes the policy for any system that is a member of the domain. Cupdate replaces the Windows 2000 command sysedit/refresh policy, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Refreshing the policy with cupdate will not help because the policy cannot be processed as applied, therefore, answer C is incorrect. The policy will not be enforced as applied, so a conflicting policy is not the problem, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 7. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with computers running Windows XP Professional. You have defined a restricted groups policy in which Joe, Jane, and Jill are the only members of the marketing group. Before you made this change, Bill, Bob, and Barbara were members. After the policy is refreshed, who will be members of the marketing group? A. Bill, Bob, and Barbara. B. Bill, Bob, Barbara, Jill, Joe, and Jane. C. Jill, Joe, and Jane. D. No one, the policy conflicts. The correct answer is C.
When a restricted groups policy is defined, any user on the members list who is not currently a member of the group is added and any current member of the group who is not on the members list is removed. Therefore, answers A, B, and D are incorrect.
Question 8. Additional security measures that should be performed on an ES server would include which of the following? Choose 3, A. Installing only necessary components. B. Enabling IaaS. C. Securing well-known accounts. D. Placing content on a dedicated disk volume.
The correct answer is C, D. Enabling IaaS is done on an IaaS server, not an ES server. Therefore, answer B is incorrect.
Question 9. On which of the following types of client computers are you likely to find a loopback policy? A. Mobile computers. B. Kiosks and email computers. C. Developer computers. D. Desktop computers. The correct answer is B. Loopback policy is used to override user-based group policy with computer-based group policy. This makes the desktop configuration the same regardless of who logs on.
Answers A, C, and D are incorrect.
Question 10. Which of the following ways can security templates be deployed? Choose 3, A, SCA console. B, command line tools. C, MBSA. D, group policy.
The correct answer is A, B, D. Security templates can be applied via the SCA console, using the group policy management console, or by command line tools and scripts.
MBSA is a tool that is used to scan one or more Windows-based computers for common security holes. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 11. You are responsible for the deployment of 15 new servers. These servers will be running Windows Server 2003. The servers all have identical hardware. Microsoft has just released a new service pack, which you have already deployed in your environment. Your company policy states all new computers must conform to the standards already in place on the network. Which of the following do you use to automate the installation of the service pack when installing the Windows Server 2003 operating system? A. Reese. B. Slipstreaming. C. SUSE. D. WOW22.NSE. The correct answer is B. Slipstreaming simultaneously installs service packs with an operating system. The installation includes the components that you want to install with the updates as entries in the spack.in file. Reese is used to automatically install client operating systems on new machines, therefore, answer A is incorrect. SUSE is used to install service packs and hotfixes, therefore, answer C is incorrect. WOW22.MSE is a Windows installer-based setup program for the automatic updates client, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 12. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with Windows XP clients. Service Pack 2 for Windows XP was just released. You want to deploy the service pack to all of your client computers with a group policy object. Which file would you use? A. Update.xls. B. Update.exe. C. Update.inf. D. Update.msi. The correct answer is D. Packages can be used to distribute service packs by making a new software installation package, .msi file, and linking it to a GPO through the computer configuration settings. Update.xls is a Microsoft Excel file, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Update.exe can be added in the GUI run once section of the unattended file for a reinstall or run by itself on a standalone machine. Therefore, answer B is incorrect. Update.inf is used in a slipstream installation. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 13. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with Windows 2000 and XP professional clients. You have several computers that, for security purposes, are not connected to the internet. You want to be able to run MCSA on these computers. Which of the following files must you download to analyze the security of the computers? A. Fetch.exe. B. Secure.xml. C. Msecure.cab. D. Msecly.exe. The correct answer is C. The Msecure.cab file is the official file offered by Microsoft for analyzing the security of computers. This is more secure than using just the XML file because it prevents customers from downloading a potentially out-of-date file. The MCSA automatically checks for the updated file before it runs a scan, therefore, answer B is incorrect. Fetch.exe and Msecly.exe will check for missing security updates but both rely on the XML database file, therefore, answers A and D are incorrect. Question 14. Your patch management coordinator receives a security bulletin that he suspects was not actually sent by Microsoft and asks for a recommendation on what to do. What is the fastest and most secure method for finding out whether or not the bulletin is valid? A. Verify that the digital signature on the bulletin belongs to Microsoft by downloading and checking the Microsoft security certificate. B. Call Microsoft support and verify the information. C. Look for a new posting on the TechNet newsgroups. D. Verify that the digital signature on the bulletin belongs to Microsoft by downloading the Microsoft SSL key. The correct answer is A. Microsoft digitally signs all security bulletins. To verify the signature, download the digital certificate. The key's fingerprint is 5E39-0633-D6B3-9788-F776-D980-AB7A-9432. Even though calling Microsoft support to verify the information and looking for a new posting on the TechNet newsgroups may be options, they are not the fastest and most secure method for finding out whether or not the bulletin is valid. Therefore, answers B and C are incorrect. The Microsoft SSL key is not available for download. Therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 15. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with Windows XP professional clients. You want to check for vulnerabilities on a certain subnet of computers. How do you accomplish this? Choose two. Each answer is part of the solution. A. Run fnetch.exe. B. Run the MCSA GUI and choose to scan multiple computers. C. Run msecly.exe from a command line prompt and specify the IP address of each computer individually. D. In the MCSA GUI, under the IP address range, specify the range of computers that you want to check.
The correct answer is B, D. To scan multiple computers, you can use the MCSA GUI and then specify the range of computers that you want to check in the IP address range.
You can also use fnetch.exe to scan multiple computers, therefore, answer A is incorrect. By using the msecly.exe from a command line, you could specify each computer individually, but it makes more sense to use a range, therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 16. You have set up a SUSE server on your network and want to test all service packs and hotfixes before they are put into your environment. How do you configure the Approve Updates page? Choose two. Each answer is part of the solution. A. Select the checkbox beside the packages you do not wish to approve. B. Clear the checkbox beside the packages you do not wish to approve. C. Click the Approve button located at the bottom of the page. D. Click the Unapprove button located at the bottom of the page.
The correct answer is B. C. To not approve updates, such as for testing purposes, clear the checkbox beside the packages you do not wish to approve and then click the Approve button located at the bottom of the page.
Selecting the checkbox beside the packages you do not wish to approve and clicking the Unapprove button located at the bottom of the page will not unapprove the update because there is no Unapprove button. Therefore, answers A and D are incorrect. Question 17. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with Windows XP and Windows 2000 professional clients. You receive a new version of a custom application with some additional security features that will benefit the company. You want to update the application with the least amount of administrative effort. Which of the following would you use? A. Woo. B. SUSE. C. SMS 2.0 with the SUSE feature pack. D. Group policy. The correct answer is C. You can use SMS to update any software product on an SMS client. In Woo and SUSE environments, custom products must be updated by using other services or by manually applying software updates, therefore, answers A and B are incorrect. Although it may be possible to update the systems by using group policy by creating an installation package, this requires more administrative work than using SMS, therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 18. You are responsible for checking that all computers on the network are secure and configured to the company's security policy. How would you use the command line version of MCSA to scan only the local computer? A. Run the MCSA.exe command line tool with the /l switch. B. Run the MCSA.exe command line tool with the /i switch. C. Run the MCSA.exe command line tool with no options. D. Run the MCSA.exe command line tool with the domain name /computer name switch. The correct answer is C. Running the MCSA.exe command line tool with no options scans the local computer. The /l switch lists the reports from the last scan, therefore, answer A is incorrect. The /i switch scans the IP address specified, therefore, answer B is incorrect. The domain name /computer name switch scans the computer named, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 19. You are the network administrator for the test domain, which consists of a Windows Server 2003 domain with Windows XP and Windows 2000 SP3 professional clients. You need to install several updates on several computers. You want the updates to install one after the other without having the computers restart after each update. Which of the following can you use to accomplish this? A. Update.exe. B. Chain.exe. C. Hotfix.exe. D. Trick.exe. The correct answer is B. Using Chain.exe, you can chain updates together so they install without restarting the computer between each installation. Chain.exe can be used with product updates that use hotfix.exe or update.exe, therefore, answers A and C are incorrect. Check.exe tracks and verifies installed Windows 2000 and Windows XP hotfixes, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 20. You are responsible for checking that all computers on the network are secure and configured to the company's security policy. Which of the following tools cannot be used to check the status of service packs or hotfixes on computers? MCSA.exe. Bfnetch.exe. Seekcheck.exe. Dupdate.exe. The correct answer is D. Update.exe can be added in the GUI run once section of the unattended file for a recent installation or run by itself on a standalone machine to update a computer. However, you cannot use it to check the status of service packs or hotfixes.
You can use MCSA.exe, Fnetch.exe, and kfcheck.exe to check the status of service packs or hotfixes on computers, therefore, answers A, B, and C are incorrect.
Question 21. Which mode of IPsec should you use to assure security and confidentiality of data within the same LAN? A, OAuth transport mode. B, ESP transport mode. C, ESP tunnel mode. D, a tunnel mode. The correct answer is B. ESP transport mode should be used to ensure the integrity and confidentiality of data that is exchanged within the same LAN. OAuth transport would only ensure the integrity of the LAN data, not the confidentiality, therefore, answer A is incorrect. ESP tunnel mode should be used to secure the integrity and confidentiality of data between networks and not within a network, therefore, answer C is incorrect. OAuth tunnel mode should be used to secure the integrity of data between networks and not within a network, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 22. Which two types of encryption protocols can be used to secure the authentication of computers using IPsec? A. Kerberos V5. B. Serificates. C. SHA. D. MD5.
The correct answer is C. D. SHA or MD5 can be used.
Kerberos V5 is an authentication protocol, not an encryption protocol, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Certificates are a type of authentication that can be used with IPsec, not an encryption protocol. Therefore, answer B is incorrect. Question 23. Which type of authentication should a company that has all computers in one domain use to ensure authentication of all clients and servers with the least administrative effort? Assume that all client computers run Windows XP Professional and all servers run Windows Server 2003. A. Certificates. B. Pre-shared keys. C. Kerberos V5. D. MD5. The correct answer is C. Kerberos V5 is the default authentication protocol for clients running Windows XP Professional and servers running Windows Server 2003 in a domain environment. Certificates would require much more administrative effort in comparison to Kerberos v5, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Pre-shared keys should only be used when absolutely necessary, therefore, answer B is incorrect. MD5 is an encryption protocol and not an authentication protocol, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 24. Which two types of IPsec can be used to secure communications between two LANs? A. A tunnel mode. B. ESP tunnel mode. C. A transport mode. D. ESP transport mode.
The correct answer is A. B. A tunnel mode IPsec should be used.
A transport mode is for protection of the integrity of data transferred between computers on a LAN, therefore, answer C is incorrect. ESP transport mode protects the integrity and confidentiality of data transferred by computers within a LAN, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 25. Which part of an IPsec policy contains filters and filter actions and controls the behavior of the policy? A. Authentication. B. Encryption. C. Tunneling. D. Rules. The correct answer is D. Rules contain filters and filter actions and control the behavior of an IPsec policy. Authentication is the process of proving an identity, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Encryption is the process of scrambling data to protect its confidentiality, therefore, answer B is incorrect. Tunneling is the process of encapsulating one protocol into another, therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 26. Which of the following are settings in an IPsec rule? Choose 2, A types of operating systems allowed. B filters. C connection types. D RAM required.
The correct answer is B, C. Parts of an IPsec rule can include filters, filter actions, authentication methods, connection types, and tunnel endpoints.
Types of operating systems allowed is not a rule setting, therefore, answer A is incorrect. RAM required is not a rule setting, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 27. Which IPsec rule setting defines traffic that is to be identified? A. Filter action. B. Filter. C. Tunnel endpoint. D. Connection type. The correct answer is B. A filter defines traffic that is to be identified. Filter action identifies how traffic will be handled after it is identified. Therefore, answer A is incorrect. Tunnel endpoint identifies the predefined IP address of the router of a remote network. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. Connection type identifies whether the connection can be LAN, dial-up, or both. Therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 28. Which two components of a rule work together to identify packets and then make decisions that affect traffic flow and security? A. Kerberos v5. B. Filters. C. Filter actions. D. Connection types.
The correct answer is B. C. Filters and filter actions work together to identify packets and then make decisions that affect traffic flow and security.
Kerberos v5 is an authentication protocol that runs by default. Therefore, answer A is incorrect. Connection types identify whether a rule applies to a LAN, dial-up, or both. Therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 29. Which AD service should you use to distribute IPsec policies that affect all of the computers in a single domain? A. AD replication. B. Kerberos v5. C. Group policy. D. Remote installation services, RIS. The correct answer is C. You should use group policy to distribute IPsec policies that affect all of the computers in a single domain. AD replication is not involved in the distribution of IPsec policies to a domain. Therefore, answer A is incorrect. Kerberos v5 is the default authentication protocol for AD, but is not involved in distributing IPsec policies. Therefore, answer B is incorrect. You can use RIS to install new clients and servers, but RIS is not involved in distributing IPsec policies. Therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 30. Which two tools should you use to create, manage, and deploy IPsec policies? A. Local security policy MMCs for each computer. B. IP security policy management console. C. Netch IPsec. D. Active directory sites and services.
The correct answer is B. C. The IP security policy management console and the Netch IPsec command can both be used to create and deploy IPsec policies.
Local security policies on each computer cannot be used to control an entire domain, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Active directory sites and services cannot be used to control the IPsec policies for a domain, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 31. Which of the following types of internet communication is secured using digital certificates? A. PPTP. B. SSL. C. PEEP. D. MSChap. The correct answer is B. SSL is secured using digital certificates. PPTP has a built-in encryption mechanism called MPPE and does not use digital certificates, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Protected Extensible Authentication Protocol, PEAP, is secured with user credentials, username and password, therefore, answer C is incorrect. MSChap is secured with user credentials, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 32. Which are essential elements of SSL communication? Choose 2, A port 80, B port 443, C public keys, D EAP.
The correct answer is B, C. Port 443 must be assigned to your website.
A public key is used to encrypt the session key created by the client. Port 80 is for HTTP, which is not secure. Therefore, answer A is incorrect. EAP allows the addition of modules that are used to configure additional security. Therefore, answer D is incorrect. Port 443 is the default port used. SSL can be configured to use any port. Question 33. Which is the strongest authentication protocol that can be used by all clients? HF. B. MSChap 2. C. MPPE. D. MSChap. The correct answer is A. CHAP is not specific to Microsoft clients and is the strongest protocol that can be used by all clients. MSChap 2 can only be used by Microsoft clients, therefore, answer B is incorrect. MPPE is an encryption protocol, not an authentication protocol, therefore, answer C is incorrect. MSChap can only be used by Microsoft clients, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 34. Which are forms of EAP authentication? Choose 2, ATLS. B. L2TP. C. MD5. DPAP. The correct answer is C. TLS authentication uses certificates to authenticate the client. It can be used with smart cards. MD5 uses algorithms to authenticate the client and the message. L2TP is a protocol used to encapsulate a message in a VPN, therefore, answer B is incorrect. PAP is a weak authentication protocol that sends the user's credentials in clear text, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 35. Which tunneling protocol can be used by all Microsoft clients? APPTP. B. L2TP. C. MSChap. D. MSChap 2. The correct answer is A. PPTP can be used by all Microsoft clients. L2TP can only be used by Windows 2000 Professional and newer clients, therefore, answer B is incorrect. MSChap and MSChap 2 are not tunneling protocols, therefore, answer C and D are incorrect. Question 36. Which are possible factors in multi-factor authentication? Choose 2, A. User's PIN. B. NAT. C. ISP. D. Fingerprint.
The correct answer is A. D. With multi-factor authentication, the user can be authenticated based on something that they have, something that they know, and or something that they are.
The user's PIN is something that they know. The user's fingerprint is something that they are. NAT is not part of multi-factor authentication, therefore, answer B is incorrect. An internet service provider is an organization that gives access to the internet and is not part of multi-factor authentication. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 37. Which tunneling protocol can always be used through a NAT? A. EAP. B. L2TP. C. MSChap. D. PPTP. The correct answer is D. PPTP can always be used through a NAT device. EAP is an authentication protocol and not a tunneling protocol. Therefore, answer A is incorrect. L2TP uses IPsec for encryption and requires NAT traversal to be used through a NAT. Therefore, answer B is incorrect. MSChap is not a tunneling protocol. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 38. Which two ports might be involved in troubleshooting tunneling protocols through a firewall? Choose 2, A, 1723/UDP. B, 1701/TCP. C, 1701/UDP. D. 1723/TCP.
The correct answer is C. D. Port 1723/TCP is assigned to point to PPTP.
Port 1701/UDP is assigned to L2TP. Port 1723/UDP is not assigned to a tunneling protocol, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Port 1701/TCP is not assigned to a tunneling protocol, therefore, answer B is incorrect. Question 39. Which component of remote access policy must the connection attributes maintain from the beginning to the end of the session? A. Conditions. B. Permissions. C. Profile. D. Encryption. The correct answer is C. Profile is checked at the beginning of the session and periodically during the session. it must be maintained throughout the session. Conditions and permissions are only checked once at the beginning of the session, therefore, answers A and B are incorrect. Encryption can be used in remote sessions, but is not a component of remote access policy, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 40. The conditions of policy that applies to a user specify access to a resource from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The profile for the same policy specifies access from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. Which are true? Choose 2. A. The user cannot access the resource until 8 a.m. B. The user cannot access the resource 10 a.m. C. The user will be forced off the connection at 5 p.m. D. The user will be forced off the connection at 8 p.m.
The correct answer is B. D. The user must meet both the conditions and the profile to access the resource.
He must then meet only the conditions of the profile to continue to use the resource. The user cannot access the resource until 10 a.m., therefore, answer A is incorrect. The user will be forced off the connection at 8 p.m., therefore, answer C is incorrect. Question 41. You are planning a multiple-tier CA hierarchy for your company. Which of the following types of CA should you keep offline as a safeguard against certificate compromise? A. Enterprise route. B. Standalone route. C. Intermediate. D. Issuing. The correct answer is B. Best practices for creating a CA hierarchy include establishing a standalone route CA that is kept offline. An enterprise route. CA should not be allowed to become out of date with regard to other Active Directory servers, therefore, answer A is incorrect. Intermediate and issuing CAs are involved in active day-to-day certificate issuing and need to be online at all times, therefore, answers C and D are incorrect. Question 42. You are planning to install certificate services as a standalone root CA on a computer running Windows Server 2003. Which of the following should you install before you install certificate services? A. Active Directory. B. DNS. C. Exchange Server. D. ES. The correct answer is D. A server running certificate services needs to have ES installed so that it can serve the certificate services web pages. You can install a standalone certificate server without installing Active Directory, therefore, answer A is incorrect. You do not need to install DNS or Exchange Server on a certificate server, therefore, answers B and C are incorrect. Question 43. You have installed a two-tier hierarchy consisting of an offline root CA plus an online issuing CA. Which of the following tasks should you perform before you begin to issue certificates to users? Choose 3. A. Configure CRLs. B. Configure certificate templates. C. Configure key archival and recovery. D. Configure the certificate services web pages.
The correct answer is A, B, C. You need to ensure that certificate templates and CRLs are configured before you are ready to issue certificates.
You should also configure key recovery and archival before issuing certificates. The certificate services web pages are created automatically when you install certificate services and need no further configuration, therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 44. You are configuring certificate services for auto-enrolling users for smart cards. However, when you access the security tab of the smart card user template, the auto-enroll permission is not present. What do you need to do so that you can allow this permission? A. Log off and log on as an enterprise administrator. B. Duplicate the template. C. Specify auto-enrollment in a GPO link to the OU containing the users that need auto-enrollment. D. Do nothing. You simply need to configure the read and enroll permissions. The correct answer is B. A version 1 template such as smart card user does not support auto-enrollment, but any duplicate of the template is created in version 2 and supports auto-enrollment. You do not need to be an enterprise administrator to configure templates. This is needed only to install a CA. Therefore, answer A is incorrect. You only specify auto-enrollment in a GPO later so that users are required to use smart cards. Therefore, answer C is incorrect. The auto-enroll permission is required for certificate auto-enrollment to be available. Therefore, answer D is incorrect. Question 45. You are configuring a certificate template for smart card auto-enrollment. When a user is creating a new smart card, you want to ensure that he is prompted to enter his PIN as part of the smart card enrollment procedure. So you open the Properties dialog box of the Certificate Template to the Request Handling tab. Which of the following options should you enable? A. Archive Subjects Encryption Private Key. B. Allow Private Key to be exported. C. Prompt the user during enrollment. D. Prompt the user during enrollment and require user input when the private key is used. The correct answer is D. Selecting the requirement for user input when the private key is used provides an opportunity for the user to enter his PIN when enrolling for the smart card certificate.
Answers A, B, and C are incorrect because none of these options produce a prompt for the PIN when the user is enrolling for the smart card certificate, although you might need to specify archival or export of the private key.
Question 46. You have configured certificate services to publish a base CRL every Monday at 6 p.m. and a Delta CRL daily at 6 p.m. on Friday morning. A financial application needs to check the CRL to ensure that a new user's certificate is valid. Which of the following CRLs does the application check? A. The base CRL and each Delta CRL published from Tuesday to Thursday. B. The base CRL and each Delta CRL published from Tuesday to Friday. C. The base CRL and Thursday's Delta CRL. D. The base CRL and Friday's Delta CRL. E. Thursday's Delta CRL only. F. Friday's Delta CRL only. The correct answer is C. Answers A and B are incorrect because the application needs to check only the base Delta CRL and the most recent Delta CRL to obtain a complete list of revoked certificates. Answer D is incorrect because the application is checking the CRL before the publication of Friday's Delta CRL. Answers E and F are incorrect because the application needs to check the base CRL as well as the Delta CRL. Question 47. You need to enable several users who are members of the domain admins group in your company's domain to archive private keys. Which of the following steps should you perform? Choose all that apply. A. Add the users to the enterprise admins group. B. Request a certificate for key recovery by using the certificate enrollment web pages. C. Add the certificate for the key recovery agent to the list of archived keys. D. Create a certificate template for key archival purposes. E. Acquire a user certificate with an archived key.
The correct answer is B, C, D, E. You need to perform all these steps to configure certificate services for key archival.
After you have performed these steps, you can recover a lost key by performing key recovery and importing the recovered private key. Answer A is incorrect because the users can belong to either the domain admins or enterprise admins groups, or to another group for which you have allowed the correct permissions. Question 48. Emily is an enterprise administrator for an Active Directory forest with three domains, examcram.com, east.examcram.com, and south.east.examcram.com. She is deploying a standalone CA server that will issue certificates for users who work for her company's partners. The certificates are to be used for authenticating and providing access to resources in the south.east.examcram.com domain. What does Emily need to do to provide access for outside users of these certificates? A. Map the certificates to user accounts in the examcram.com domain. B. Map the certificates to user accounts in the east.examcram.com domain. C. Map the certificates to user accounts in the south.east.examcram.com domain. D. Map the certificates to user accounts on the standalone CA. The correct answer is C. Emily needs to map the certificates to user accounts in the domain in which the resources to be accessed are located. Answers A and B are incorrect because the resources to be accessed are not in either of these domains. Answer D is incorrect because this would not provide any means of access to the resources. Question 49. Which of the following procedures can you use to backup certificate services? Choose all that apply. A. Usenet backup to backup the system state data. B. Usenet backup to backup the certificate services folder. C. In the certificate snap-in, right-click certificate's current user and choose all tasks, backup CA. D. In the certification authority snap-in, right-click the certificate server and choose all tasks, backup CA.
The correct answer is A, D. Either of these procedures backs up the certificate server.
Answer B is incorrect because there is no specific certificate services folder. Answer C is incorrect because the certificates snap-in does not provide an option for backing up the CA. Question 50. Adam has set up an enterprise CA to serve EFS certificates in his company's Active Directory domain. He has installed the web enrollment pages in another server in the domain that is already running EIS. However, users are unable to connect to these pages. What should Adam do? A. Configure the pages to use NTLM authentication. B. Configure the pages to use basic authentication. C. Configure the pages to use anonymous authentication. D. Configure the pages to use .NET Passport authentication. The correct answer is B. In this case, the pages were configured to use NTLM authentication rather than Kerberos authentication. Answer A is incorrect because NTLM authentication is what is causing this problem. Answer C and D are incorrect because these authentication methods do not solve this problem.